Hello everybody, I have made this project. It's a treasure chest and today I will show you how it has turned out to be. This is something that I had made for my friend Ushma for her birthday, and it took me around 2 months. That was because I was not working continuously on this project, and I must have worked for 2 hours maybe every day. And I made this from scratch, so it took me around 2 days first to figure out the design and then plan it out, chalk it out, and then should have taken me roughly around 2 months to finish this project. So I've made this from scratch, and I'm going to show you all the supplies that I've used for making this box. It's incredibly sturdy. She's a stationery holder and she doesn't have anything nice to hold all her things. So when I saw that, I thought she needed some help, and I made this for her. So this is made using 1500 GSM cardboard, which I brought from a local stationery store called as Anupam in Borivali, and I have combined it with sunboard. So the entire outer exterior of the box is made with cardboard and sunboard. So here I have a piece of the cardboard left. So if you see, it is really thick and really sturdy, and if you measure it, it's around 1/8 of an inch. Yes, it's 1/8 of an inch in thickness, and the sunboard is around 1/4 inch in thickness. So together I sandwiched them and then I built this box. Let's first talk about the exterior, and then maybe I'll open it up and show you. So for the exterior, I have used sunboard and all, and covered it with handmade paper which I have bought from Itsy Bitsy, and they have incredible collection of papers. So this is white handmade paper and black handmade paper which I bought from Itsy Bitsy, and they have amazing collection of papers, and this is what I've used to cover the box. Then I got a free haul from them some while ago, which consisted of this black beautiful pigmenting pad and a stencil, and this is what I have used for the entire box to give it nice pattern. And they had also given me a bottle of silicone glue. I must have it somewhere. Yeah, silicone glue. So this has been a major help for me in sticking lot of things and adhering them in place. So this is what I have used. Now for the box, what I have done, the change in color has happened because I have applied a coat of gesso on the bottom part, and then I have done stenciling, and on the upper part I have not applied any gesso on it. So that is why the colors have shown the way they are. I have used distress inks for stenciling. This is old paper, and I've used antique linen, and I've used walnut stain, vintage photo, and black soot. These are the colors that I have used for distressing, for creating a background. It was really fun doing that, and I had great time. I have never stenciled on such a huge project. As you can see, it's big, and I haven't really measured the dimensions yet. So let us see. It is around 16 inches in length, and let me see, it is 11.5 inch in breadth, and the height is 14 inches. So that is 16 by 11.5 by 14 inches. That is the length, breadth and height for this box. So let's open this up. Yeah, I just forgot. The corners are made by chipboard, and these are something I made on my own. I just cut this shape from a chipboard piece, and then I bend them in such a way that, you know, it gave a nice corners. We get metal corners, but I thought I should do it on my own, and then I gave it a coat of glossy accents. That is what gives this piece shine, and I also learned that it makes it more sturdy. So that's why I gave it a coat of glossy accents. The upper part, the coat that I have put, and happiness is doing what you love, is made by Itsy Bitsy chipboard accents. This is something that I had got a while ago. I bought it, and they are incredible. I've used them a number of times. They're very sturdy, very nice. As you can see, this is letter C. So these letters are what I have used to make her name tag, and as well as to do this. What I have done is I have taken those letters, and they had sent me this pigmenting pad, which is incredibly jet beautiful black. I have coated it up with that and I just smudged it on the letters, and I gave them also the borders. I've covered them also using the same ink pad. So from no matter from where you see, it always looks nice black. And then I gave nice coat of glossy accents on them, and I sprinkled some micro beads in golden and bronze. So this is something I had also bought from Itsy Bitsy. I don't think this is the way you should open it. Okay, I usually open it like this so nothing comes off. Okay, so this is micro beads, this is bronze, and that one is in golden. I'm sure you can see that. So this is what I have used. I just sprinkled it while the glossy accents was wet, and excuse me for a moment please, I'll just put this back. Okay, yeah, huh. So I just sprinkled them while it was wet, and it just got set and nothing comes off. As you can see, this is the thing that just fell off. See, if you can, I just rub it and nothing comes off. Glossy accent is incredible adhesive, nothing comes off from it. And these butterflies I had bought from D-Stash from A1 craft store in Andheri. It comes in, I think, a set of 20 butterflies in a pack, and that is what I adhered to it. These letters were adhered on the white handmade paper, which I further adhered on black, and then these are foam mounted. So this scotch foam tape is what I have used to mount them. So this is a foam mounting tape which I have used, and it's really nice. It's very adhesive and always holds to a surface, but because this is something which I know is going to be used a lot, I have added silicone glue to everything just for that additional support and nothing comes off from it. So that is what I have used. Everywhere I have dabbed silicone glue. And on the front, this is a paper tape, and I don't have that left, but it came in a pack of 6, and it's really nice. I like the pattern it went with this, so I've used that. And this is also paper tape, and that's got over, but it also came in a pack of 12, and that is what I have used here for the box. This is satin ribbon again, which I have bought from Itsy Bitsy. They have awesome collection of satin ribbons. And this is again the paper tape. These flowers were from my stash. This is something I had for a while, and I just gave it a black coat of, I think, 3D liner. That is what I have used to give it a little bit of antique look and add a little more interest to the box. Same goes with the name tag. The name was made with glossy accents. I've left it plain, didn't add any micro beads. And this is a piece of sunboard which I covered with the handmade white paper, mounted this on the black paper, and I have used brads. I've used brads to just for decoration, though it is glued with silicone glue. This is just for decoration, makes it look more like hammered inside. And this is a chunky glitter which I recently bought from Itsy Bitsy. It comes in a pack of 3, bronze, I think this is silver grey, and this is black, really black hickory smoke colour. And I just dabbed some glue on it and just spread it over it, just to give it a little more, you know, I don't know, texture, dimension, beauty. I just did that because I had it and I had to use it somewhere, so I just used it. And then this is a latch that I bought from A1 craft store, and with that I have used 2 more latches here to hold this part to the box. This comes off, and this is the top which is held together by hinges. These hinges are again bought from A1 craft store in Andheri. This is all what I did on the front. Now let's open this up and see how it turns out. This is just a normal lock which I stole from my husband. I think it's the another key. Let me try. I'm sorry. I didn't know that I had to select the key while I was stealing it. Yay! So we are in. This is again a part of I think it's chipboard, not sunboard, that I have used, and I gave it that long thing to just attach the latch onto it. So this is how this opens. So let me just incline it to the wall so we can see much better. Okay. This is how it opens. Yeah, it opens completely, but then I want it to be like this so you can see the interior part of it. This is the interior white, again handmade paper. I have not done anything, and this is the paper tape that I have used. This however is a stamp set from Fiskars. It's called Swirls of Fun. This is what I have used to decorate it. I have just repetitively stamped over it using the same black pigment ink pad from Itsy Bitsy. That is what I have used. You can see it's really, really beautifully black. Nowhere there's a problem except for where I have not stamped it properly. Same stamp I have used on the inside also to stamp it. Now this is a box that I didn't want it to look very new and very crisp. I wanted it to look like an antique chest. So at places, you know, I have rubbed off paint and I have some peeled textures. This is all part of the thing so that, you know, it doesn't look like it's newly bought or something. And as I was talking, I told you, with the sandwich chipboard and the sunboard, it makes it incredibly thick. See, this is how thick it becomes. And that helped me to build it, and it's really sturdy. Again, these papers are from Itsy Bitsy. Okay, so this paper is again from Itsy Bitsy. And these were the boxes that I made for her. They are made from normal chipboard, nothing 1500 JSM. I think they must be around 400 or 600 JSM cardboard. And I covered them with this pattern paper from Eno Greetings. I have it here. Let me show you the paper pack I've used. I don't remember what it is. But, oh, okay. The bits and pieces are falling off. This is what I have used. I don't know the name and I can't see anywhere. This is what I have used, and very few sheets of papers have been left. I don't think much is left. I'm not sure even if there is one. Yeah, I just used up all of it. Only one sheet is left. So I used around a lot of sheets. I did a mini album using the same paper. So a lot of them is not left. This is what I have used. Very beautiful, very vintage. And I covered the box using this paper. All the boxes are used with the same paper pack. These are some embellishments that I think die cuts that were part of this collection. And I had to buy them separately, like an ephemera pack. I just did that. And this is one, this is two. They're all different. See, there's a beautiful sticker that I got from the same pack. And I mounted it on black chipboard and I just adhered it. And this is another one. There's a beautiful key which goes beautifully with this lock and key theme. And this is a craft paper. This is three boxes. And this is something I did for my friend because she loves stationery. These are normal pencils, I think from Apsara or Nataraj, I'm not very sure. These papers were from the same collection, and these were the little itty bitty tits that were left after I did a lot of covering. I just decoupaged them using Mod Podge mat. This was a cool thing that I did, but I couldn't use a sharpener to sharp them, so I had to use a blade to sharp them up, and I tied them. These are covered with glitter. I think these are glitter strips from Itsy Bitsy, and this chunky glitter is also from Itsy Bitsy. After I decoupaged it, I just dipped them in there, and it really made it look, gave it something extra. And I really love these pencils. I have engraved this is really cute thing that I did. I engraved each and every pencil with her name and HB brand. So that is something I did for her, an extra touch, just to show her that she's really special. So this is what I did. Then these latches that I had attached on the side, they completely help you to attach this part to the box, and this completely comes off. This is how it comes off. Now this is again that I had made on my own. I just used an extra sheet of sunboard to attach. And this is a box that I built from, again, the same combination of sunboard and chipboard. What this does is it doesn't put pressure on this part. These are just decorative flaps that I had used. And I didn't want anything to just put pressure and break it. So I had to do this box in such a way that, you know, it obstructs its force here and all the pressure comes here rather than on this. So that helped me to do this. These are the flaps. This again is a stamp. This is a paper from Eno collection. This is paper from Itsy Bitsy. This is a stamp again from the same set, Swirls from Fiskars. I've stamped it using vintage photo ink. This is what I've used to stamp it. I just made four flaps. This is something I designed on my own, and it took a lot of time to figure out how the flaps should work and function. I'm sorry, I don't have a lot of measurements because this is something that I randomly made. And it opens up like this, and I just added a few eyelets to them. So yeah. I'm sorry, I'm taking short breaks in between because my husband is shooting the video and he's getting tired holding the camera. So yeah, so this is a gold ribbon that it's an organza ribbon. I think that's what you call it. It's an organza ribbon. I just knotted it. I just hammered some eyelets and I just passed it through them. So it gives you a nice thing. You can just knot it up and it looks really pretty. And these are the latches that I wanted you to show. This, unfortunately, I just had one. I bought these three, and this is what holds the box to the side, and you just have this thing that you insert it and the lock doesn't come off. And I didn't attach them with brads. I have used little screws which are usually used for computer products and all. I've used those screws to, you know, screw them up inside. Throughout the project I have used red tacky for attaching all this red tacky tape, as well as Aline's thick glue. So this is good, as well as at places I've used Fevicol also, depending upon how sturdy I want it to be. I've used products like this, and this opens up like this, and inside again we have two boxes. These again are from the same collection. This was something that was provided inside the paper pack, and I just mounted it on black chipboard, added a ribbons. So these ribbons are again from Itsy Bitsy. I really like this box. And this is another box that I made. This is again parchment paper from Itsy Bitsy. This is black handmade paper, and this paper is from Eno Collection. This is a movable tag that I made, and I really loved it. It swirls around the way you want it. It says life, and this is a nice gramophone. Again mounted on chipboard. Looks really pretty. And this side it says friend. This is again, it was a big thing that I just cut off and tore it off, and I made my own tag. So yeah, so this is how this works. You know, this stands up because I have given a little support below this, which is made from cardstock. That is why it stands up like this. Otherwise, you know, it would have just kept moving down. I just gave those supports. It doesn't really help much, but yes, it holds it up. So here is the last layer. This is made from cardboard, and I've added eyelets. This is again a satin ribbon. So this is how it works. So when you push it up tightly, it holds the upper things together. I have made it such, and this is really nice. This is how it holds. Okay. And these are again held by the same things, and I have attached the same chipboard pieces here. This is how it helps the lid to hold up and does not let it slip down. These partitions are again same chipboard. I've attached them using silicone glue. I can't stop talking about silicone glue because it's amazing, and really you should use it to know how good it is. That's a really awesome product that Itsy Bitsy have come up. These are again the boxes, and yeah, this is Itsy Bitsy crayon. She likes little tiny stuff, and this is something I got free with the pencils. So I just left it here, and they're really cute crayons. I'm sure it's meant for children, but my friend will love it as much. So this is the box, how it looks from inside. This is how it is. Since it is empty now, we can twirl it around and I can show you. Yeah, though it is heavy, I have weighed it, and together it comes up around 4 kilos. This is how heavy the box is. This is the downside. I have stenciled everywhere. These are the corners. Okay. This is another box, and a beautiful die cut mounted on chipboard. These are some sharpeners. I just added a little touch to them, covered them with my own paper, and did some stamping, added a little stamps. This is happy, and this is friend. These are erasers and sharpeners and everything. So just a beautiful collection. She loves all these little things. This is a very special box, and it says for someone special. Indeed, it is for someone special. These are all the diaries that I made for her on my own. They are 5 diaries. The papers are from Eno Collection. I think I must have used another pack, but they are definitely all from Eno Collection. This is one diary. This is a beautiful die cut and some baker's twine pearls. This is handmade paper from Itsy Bitsy. It's tied up. This is another one. Added corners. Beautiful die cut. says good time at the back, and this is how it opens. It's incredibly easy to make these handmade papers, diaries, very simple. And the best of friends is another thing, and I gave a beautiful bookmark as well, which is a part of the collection. This butterfly is again from Itsy Bitsy. I'm telling you, their embellishments are awesome. Pearls are from Itsy Bitsy. This is, you know, collection. This is the same paper tape. I think I don't have that color right now, but same polka dotted paper tape. This paper is something that I had in my stash. This is a die cut from Eno Greeting. Same way. Another beautiful embellishment from Itsy Bitsy. This is from Eno Greeting. Papers from Eno Greeting. Satin ribbon is from Itsy Bitsy. Another beautiful diary. So I'm sure she'll love all this. So yes, that brings us to the end of one beautiful project that I hope, I think you liked it as much as I did. This is dedicated to my friend, and I'm sure you must have got inspired. I'm sorry I don't have any measurements, no tutorial. I was just happy to finish it and I wanted to show it. Tomorrow is the day I'm giving it to her, so I just wanted to do a video to show you what I did before I send it off. This is my box, and I hope you all like it. If you do, please visit my blog on vrenchanted.blogspot.in. I'm also available on Facebook. If you want to ask me anything about these box, I'm more than glad to help you. You can leave your comments even on the YouTube video. I'll get back to you. Please do mention your name and numbers if you want me to get in touch with you. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you have a good time. See you again with another project. Till then, keep crafting and keep smiling. Bye-bye.